Bears, Panthers on EA Sports. We welcome you to Charlotte, North Carolina for today's game.
This is a game today that could come down to the two running backs,
two of the real stars of the sport, two players who went in fantasy drafts really high. How do you see this one going down today?
Yeah, and how's your fantasy team?
Yeah, we won't talk about that. We'll talk about good things. But, you know, these two teams are stars. You know why? Because we can see how the football team is built. And I think it is no doubt about it. The offensive line's a big part of it. They always have hope that they block their guy a little bit. These running backs can make a big play out of it.
Look at the linebackers moving around. They're trying to confuse the quarterback.
Slashes to the left side. Ends up picking up 3 yards. He is one of the biggest targets you'll find on the outside of the entire league. Kelvin Benjamin by way of Florida State.
Well, he's so big. When you meet him, you can't believe he's a wide receiver. Not only is he tall, but he's also thick. And that's what he uses all that to his advantage. He goes down the field and he can just manhandle defensive backs and make catches.
Gains 12. Three-step drop. Out to Ginn.
Tackle down right around the 48.
Well, when you throw in the slant route, it's all about accuracy from the quarterback standpoint. Make sure you put it right on the receiver where he can catch it, protect himself. Good job that time, and almost gets a first down.
Takes it on the draw. They have this one covered up, and it's going to set them back for a loss. Now, looking at third down. McPhee takes down the quarterback.
Well, the defense has got to be excited. Anytime on third down they make the play, they get pretty fired up. But when you sack a quarterback on third down, that is one happy and emotional defense right now.
Dixon's tackled down at the 38.
Anytime you decide to run the football in a punting situation, you're trying to fake the defense out. Man, you got to fool them completely. Why? Because your best runner on the football team is not the guy that's going to be running it in a situation like this. It looked good for a second, but not able to get the first down.
The Panthers defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. The Bears take it from the 38. Rodgers got on the handle. Here's the starting offense with a receiving core that can be so dangerous in a game like this.
Coming to the line at the 34.
The Bears have it at the 34. Rodgers, right side. And when it comes to the defense, the buck stops here. Jared Allen, always a force.
Yeah, it sure does. The big old cowboy can get it done. He knows how to pressure the quarterback and get him to the ground.
Breaking huddle at the 30-yard line. And the offense will call a timeout. Okay. third down. Rodgers lined up as the single back. Very nearly intercepted.
Good job that time by the defense on third down. Find a way to get off the field. The defender found a way. Knocked that pass down.
Gold set now to attempt the field goal. The field goal attempt is good. It's good. That field goal gives them a leg up here midway through the first quarter.
Makes you feel really good about what you did during the week here. Anytime you can get points on the board early in a football game, it makes you think all that practice was worth it.
And this is Whitaker running it out. And he's out across the 20 and tackled at the 21.
The Panthers take the field here. Their last possession ended with the very crazy decision going for it on fourth down from their own territory. An unusual decision, to say the least.
I don't know if it's unusual. We see this all the time from this guy. So it's when you're going to learn. You know, I guess when you pile up enough losses, you finally say, hey, I've got to win a game. I'm going to manage it differently. And in those situations, you should win.
Okay, if you were playing the game right now, what would you have done with that last possession?
I absolutely would have punted it without question.
Newton's ready for the snap. Empty backfield. Snap it out of the gun. And that picks up three. This defensive front has been the talk all week long. And Phil, we met with them in our production meetings this week. They know they'll have a chance to get to the quarterback today.
Coming to the line at the 49.
Cam Newton will take the snap out of the gun.
Second down and seven.
Billy Brown with the catch.
This is third down.
Newton standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Makes the catch in open space. Set up now at the 39-yard line. Newton's got no one behind him. Just a quarterback waiting for the snap. Almost intercepted.
Incompletion by the quarterback that time. It was good, tight, man-to-man coverage.
Second down. The corner step back. Newton has everybody split out wide for the snap. And they're all over him for the sack.
Well, if your offensive line's not good enough just to stop the pass rush, then you got to help them out. How do you do that? Well, you keep the tight end in, let him be an extra blocker, and you tell your running backs to help out, too, blocking some of these defensive linemen.
Third down now. And the second quarter is underway with this snap. Jarring hit that time. Knocks the ball free. Lots of game left, but that stop gives the offense a chance to extend the lead.
You said it, long way to go, but get momentum on your side. Find a way to come out here as an offense and put some points on the board.
Going for it on fourth down. The Panthers come out with a split backfield. Newton's going to take it from the gun. Cotchery's got it on a pass that had some heat.
The Panthers took a big gamble going for on fourth down, and they got it. Now, can you take advantage of that big gamble?
It's first down as they head to the line. Here's the first snap after the big play. Handoff to Jonathan Stewart. Stewart's tackled down after a gain of 10.
If I'm on the defense and the offense is this close to scoring, I'll tell you what I'm doing. I am sending everybody. I am going to gamble that it is a run. If they have the courage to throw it, let them. If they do, of course, it'd be a touchdown.
Jonathan Stewart with the football. They bring him to the turf. This drive now about to reach the 10th play of the series. Dropping back three. Makes the grab. Touchdown. That touchdown partner puts them in front here in the early part of the second quarter.
Yeah, it's nice. They scored that touchdown. The defense has got to be kicking themselves because they did not play well or smart on that scoring drive.
And the extra point is good. The Panthers setting up for the kickoff. Just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line.
The Bears step back onto the field on offense. Their last possession resulted in a field goal.
Well, I know this. It was good defense on the other side. That's what made them kick that field goal. So the defense is feeling good about the fact that they stopped that momentum by the offense and made them kick that field goal.
Rodgers lined up directly behind the quarterback here. The Bears from the 22. The catch is made. Ball is out, and it's a takeaway. White's there to take it down midway through the second, and that fumble recovery is huge, Phil Sims. Before there's another snap, the officials want to go back and take a look at that last one. So now they're going to take a look at whether the knee was down before the ball came out.
Well, when we look at this, let's look when the knee hits the ground. And as we look at it, when the knee hits the ground, does he still have total control of the football? If you deem him to have total control, then it's not a fumble.
First down at the 44. Rodgers looking for a lane. And it's now second down and 5 after running it on first down. The catch inbounds.
Well, the corner route. Some people call it the corner route. They call it a flag, run to the flag of the end zone, or a 7 route. Odd numbers break out. That time we see a nice route by the receiver and a good throw by the quarterback.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion.
Jay Cutler from the shotgun.
The play to an end.
That was an awesome job by the defense. They just read the quarterback's eyes. They got in position and they made the interception.
The Panthers offense heading back onto the field to start the drive after the result of their last possession was a touchdown. You think they've got another one in them, partner?
Oh, I absolutely do. I mean, just look at it. They got a good football team. The quarterback has great confidence and talent. And you put those things together, that makes you good. It makes you dangerous. And I wouldn't be surprised to see him march down there again.
And now we reach the 2-minute warning here in the second quarter. And it'll be second down and 6 after the running play on first down. Ready, ready, ready.
to the ground.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit here. You want to stop the offense from scoring here with under 2 minutes to go in the first half. Good pressure on the quarterback, and they take him down behind the line of scrimmage.
The Panthers come to the line with an empty backfield.
From the gun, Newton. And that's going to be a three and out.
Sometimes when you have a player with this kind of talent, you're willing to put up with a few drop passes because when he catches it, he has a chance of going all the way.
He's tackled right at the 24.
Well, that's nothing but just that's just luck. That's all you can say. You're the return team. They fumble the football. It bounces out, and they get it back. They lucky there.
The Bears have it at the 24. What a run by Rodgers.
Rodgers is a very smart runner. He knows situations in the game. He saw the first down yard markers, and what does he do? He gets past them and picks up the first down.
First and 10. Has Royal.
So far, wonderful execution in this drive. When you get a chance to get out of bounds, here the offensive player got the yardage, had a chance, gets out of the bound, stops the clock. Good job by the offense. Quarterback likes what he sees out there outside. He's changing the play with the wide receiver.
Short has the sack.
That's an excellent job by the defense. Just gets quick penetration in there, hits the quarterback and gets the sack. That clock keeps moving. What a job by the defense in this situation.
Ball at the 47. Cutler steps back into the gun. He's wide open for the grab from inside the red zone.
Good job of hurrying up and getting on that football and trying to get the play off. Don't use the timeout here. Good clock management. Snap that football.
Locked in on the football and has hold of it with two hands.
Nice job that time by the runner. Gets out of bounds after the play. You got under 2 minutes, and you need to stop the clock, so he gets it done.
The pass play was good for five. Second and five coming up. Rodgers lined up as the single back. And it's incomplete. Just couldn't hold on to it after the hit.
Good timing by the defensive player that time. He gets to the receiver just as the football is getting there and makes the hit, knocks that football loose.
Third and five following the incompletion. Jay Cutler takes a look now from under center. And Chicago, touchdown. And as we near the half, the lead now is theirs thanks to that touchdown.
Yeah, you know, look at that. Just think about how much that changes the mentality of both teams. One now all psyched up and emotionally feeling great. And the defensive side, oh, my gosh, they are down and have to be disappointed about how they played on that drive.
Webb's going to test the coverage this time. Anderson's in on the tackle. That return's good for about 21. The Panthers' offense coming back onto the field here, desperately trying to avoid a repeat of their last drive when they had the quick three and out.
I'll tell you what, if they go three and out again, you know what's going to happen? Those defensive players are going to be looking at them as they come off the field. You're putting this back out there already, so it's important to get a drive, give your defense a little rest.
first down at the 17. Cam Newton unleashes the long pass, and it falls incomplete.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit there, don't you, Jim? They are all over the receivers, all over the field, nowhere to throw it, and it just results in an incompletion.
Second down after the incompletion. Newton's all by himself in the backfield for this snap. Out of the shotgun. They're going to get him here for a sack. The Panthers signal for a timeout. They have two remaining. Third down after the sack. Newton in shotgun formation. Olsen's got it. First down. Marquette down for another reception. The Panthers will use a timeout here. They'll talk it over before running a play on first down. Ready for intermission. First, one more play.
Doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals.
And it's incomplete. Neither offense able to pull away in a first half that saw two defenses matching each other step for step. Larry Ridley coming up next to break down this first half. With this kick, the second half is underway. And they're all over him at the 18-yard line. The Bears offense takes the field. Let's see if this momentum can carry over from the first half, because they have been brilliant to this point, Parker.
Yeah, a lot of things change in that locker room at halftime. You know, you might feel good about what you've done. Of course, you got to realize the defense might be upset and is willing to come out here and take more chances in the second half.
First down at the 18. Strong eye, handoff here. And it'll be second down and 6 after the running play on first down. Double tight end formation. Rodgers taking the handoff. He's tackled beyond the markers. It's a first down.
Good job by the offense picking up a first down there. They've been terrific all day long. They're winning the football game, and they are tiring this defense out.
Jay Cutler takes a look now from under center. The Bears have it at the 29. Rodgers, right side. Rodgers met after a gain of 3. He's now averaging 6 yards a carry on the day. And it'll be second down and 6 after the running play on first down. He'll throw it over the middle. That's dropped by Jeffrey, who couldn't bring it in. The Bears have really not looked great passing the football, but you wouldn't be able to tell it looking at the scoreboard. Cutler's numbers, though, speak to a team that maybe shouldn't be so fortunate right now, as the passing attack has not been there all day long.
No, the passing game has not worked great, no doubt about that. But look, there's a lot of ways to win in the NFL, and sometimes you have to overcome average play by the quarterback.
Not punting. Going to go for it on fourth down. Two tight ends on the field here. The Bears from the 32. And it's spotted away.
When you're winning a game in the second half, when you go for it on fourth down and you come come up short, I'm telling you what, if you lose this football game, there is going to be a lot of second guessing going on. That was a big gamble, and it didn't pay off.
First down at the 32. Ted Ginn takes it in. After the catch, it's now second down and one. Wasting little time. Stewart's handed the football. Young's all over that offense and brings him down.
Look at that. The defensive line, now they're all spreading out.
The Panthers from the 27.
This offense can't be stopped on third down, no matter the distance.
Jim, when you get inside the other team's red zone, inside the 20-yard line, and you're down some points, you're thinking touchdown in these situations.
Now first and 10. Ginn has the reception. Getting set as fast as they can. Midway into the third. Touchdown, Carolina. Benjamin, second touchdown of the game.
Nice throw by the quarterback that time. Put it right on the money. Not a big window. It doesn't matter to him today. Great control of the football. Put it right in there for the touchdown.
Driving extra point is good. The Bears are ready to return the kick. And they stop him from running it out to the 20. Mark him down at the 19. Comes out in the pistol. First down at the 19. Harper's able to read that play and make the hit.
The Bears running back that time, he makes a bad decision. You can't be looking to make every play a big play when you're running the football. Look for a few yards, take advantage of that. He tries for the big play. What happens? He gets tackled for a loss.
Rodgers going to secure the handoff. Rodgers met after a gain of 8. He's now over 50 yards rushing on the day. After that last carry, it's 3rd and 3. The Panthers' defense now is going to go nickel. They hand it off to him again. They bring him down, and the offense fails to pick up a first down on 3 plays. The offense is still on the field here on 4th down, needing 6 for the first. Cutler is back in shotgun formation. The Bears turn the ball over on downs.
Well, it's in the second half. When your team is losing, here is a 4th down situation, and you feel like you just got to go for it. I don't know if I agree with that call, but they try it. They come up short. That is deflated.
Hey, the offense has a chance to do something with this drive.
The Bears with a nickel look here on defense. The Panthers take it from the 23. Stewart's tackled right at the 20.
The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
2nd down and 7. The Panthers now move the chains. Touchdown, Carolina Panthers. We're almost in the 4th, and they've just increased their lead. Could it be time to rest the starters, Phil?
Oh, no, Jim, not even close to that yet. We've got a long way to go. You've seen it many times in the NFL. Big leads have a way of just disappearing. So I'm not counting this one over by any means.
The Panthers for the extra point. They better hurry to get the snap.
Extra point was good.
The Panthers getting set to kick it away.
Takes it from the two. And the tackle's made right around the 25-yard line. Rodgers is in the backfield. The Bears will take the snap from the 25. Bennett's going to pull in the bullet pass.
I like this. Show some patience. Don't try to get it all in one play. Pick up first downs and try to go down the field and score.
Cutler's completion percentage, 50% on the day. First down here after the completion. They're going back up top. Oh, and almost picked off that time. Second and 10 coming up. The Bears come out in a bunch set. White's got the catch and the first. The Bears are still in possession as we get this final quarter underway. Quarter underway now with this snap. And Jared Allen's going to bring the quarterback down.
Man, this defensive end, Jim, he is some talent. That time, good job, makes the move, shows the speed, and gets around there and gets the sack.
We'll set up now at midfield.
Cutler's got it in the gun. Bennett had it but couldn't hold it as this goes incomplete.
Good job that time by the secondary. They're in good position. They make the play, and it's an incomplete pass by the quarterback.
Forte's going to take the handoff now. The coach is going to go for it. The Panthers lined up in the nickel. Jay Cutler from the shotgun. Going deep. It's intercepted.
Keekly's able to show off those great hands and picking off that pass from the linebacker position. What a job and what a pair of hands.
Loss of two on that play.
The Panthers on a quest for their third straight scoring drive here, Phil. They've been having their way with that defense on these last few possessions.
Well, let me say this, Jim. It's not that easy to score points in the NFL. Not the way they're making it look. And they're confident. They look like they're fast. They're fresh. They're rested. It's been fun to watch.
This will be second down.
Cam Newton takes a look now from under center.
Play clock's running down.
Easy catch there. No one near him.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. Trying to beat the play clock.
Stewart's got it on the screen. Quarters all over the ball carrier.
Well, we see it more and more. Football's thrown behind the line of scrimmage. They do it that time. Nice catch, but a loss of yards on the play.
Second and 13. Looking across the middle. Intercepted by Andrell Rowe. And he's brought to the ground.
Nice job of the defense that time. In position, they read the quarterback's eyes, and it led to an interception.
The Bears will try to hold on to the football. This has been one big turnover after another, Phil. Just what the coaches talked about in our meetings with them this week about ball security. It's not happening here.
Well, it tells you the players did not listen to the coaches, that's for sure, because ball security is not what we're seeing out there. I know this. Next week in practice, there's going to be a lot of drills about hanging on to the football.
Cutler steps back into the gun.
A nice grab. No doubt he was going to hold on to that one.
Coming to the line at the 27.
Zebra.
2 minutes to go before this one's in the books. First down, pressure on every snap now.
The Panthers defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel.
Look at that concentration as he makes the grab.
Here they are inside the 20, and they keep their hopes alive as they move down the field.
Yeah, they've done that. Now they got to do the hard part. When you get to this part of the field in the red zone, we know the defense is not worried.
That's a touchdown, and that tightens things up. While that touchdown edges them closer to the lead, it may be a case of too little, too late in this game, Phil.
Well, it could be, Jim, but listen, I'm going to say this. It's never over. Remember 2015, the Seattle Seahawks had the Green Bay Packers in their place. I thought the game was over many times, but the Seahawks hung in there, and they found a way to pull it out.
So, put down a touchdown and a two-point conversion on that occasion.
Yeah, good job by the offense. They executed the play perfectly, and they got it in the end zone, like you said, got that 2 points.
Whitaker on the return. And he spins away.
And they stop him from running it out to the 20. Mark him down at the 19.
The Panthers' offense is on the field, and they are sitting pretty with the lead late in this game, Phil.
I like the way they are sitting in this game. You said it, Jim, and I'll tell you what. All the pressure goes to the defense. Can the defense find a way to get them off the field, three downs and out, and make them punt?
No bump coverage here. Corners backing up.
First down at the 19.
Now makes the move to the right. Brown's tackled down after a gain of five.
Jim, that's just playing it by the book. You got the lead, and you want to keep the clock moving, so what do? You run the football. When you're in the huddle, as a quarterback in this type of situation, you just tell everybody two things. Stay in bounds and put two hands on the football.
The Bears will stop the clock here with this timeout, needing to preserve time. Cam Newton will take the snap out of the gun. The Panthers have it at the 24. He's tackled beyond the markers. It's a first down.
Situations like this, when you're looking to get that one first down to win the game, it's tough because the defense knows there's only a few plays that you're going to try to run, but the offense gets it done. Great job.
The Bears stop the clock in a hurry, trying to hold on to every precious second. First down and 10. Newton's on the move. Gains 16. The Bears will call for the timeout. They need every second to be preserved at this point. Final 30 seconds, and it's a first down. First down at the 49. Now slashing to the right side, looking for room.
Well, Jim, they got the lead. There's not much time left. Run the football on this clock. Keep it moving, and you can win the game. Take no chances. Don't jump off sides. Don't create a penalty, and put two hands on the ball.
This was a close one that came down to the wire. What's that feeling on the sideline right now on the winning side?
Oh, it's awesome. When games are close, you're down on the sideline. You look up there every once in a while and you go, oh, I hope we can find a way to win this game today. They did it. It is truly extremely exciting once you get it done.
So for Phil Sims and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nantz saying so long for now.